Chairman, not being from a legal background, sir, the first thing I did today was to check what exactly is a negotiable instrument, sir. And the answers I got from dictionaries and Googles and all was, it's a promise or an order to pay a certain amount of money at a specified time or on demand. There's no choice, sir. If I write a check, is such a negotiable instrument? If I write out a check, I have to pay that amount. That amount has to be in the bank at the time it is presented to the bank, sir. So, English is a very strained language, sir. There's a word called onomatopoeia, which means the word sounds like its meaning. Example, boom, and certain examples are there. But this one sounds exactly and means exactly opposite of the word, sir. Because a check in English language is a negotiable instrument, which actually nothing can be negotiated. Neither the time or the amount or the payee, nothing can be negotiated. So I think not only the bill needs amendment, sir, the English language itself needs amendment. So, yes. So there are many, many. So nothing is negotiable. Probably some of these check writers who have a habitual check bouncers are mistaking the literal English word for negotiable instrument where nothing is negotiable, sir.
Well, let him finish afterwards.
Sir, also, the number of check bouncing cases in this country are phenomenal. 38 lakhs in 2008. Some recent figures shows something like 60 lakhs plus check bouncing cases, which are literally clogging the courts and the judicial system, where I think the burden on the judiciary is even very high for all the other cases, and this is only adding to that, sir. However, I must say this is welcome, and the 20% interest to be paid by the complainant is very good, because there are also some fake cases of check bouncing, sir. So it protects even the person who writes the check, or at least a fake claim against me. I am forced to pay 20%, and if I win the case, that they have to pay the back the 20% with the interest. So some of these are very, very good points, sir. But it has to have teeth. The sword needs to be really, really sharp, sir. We have what in this bill is a little blunter sword, sir. Usually check bouncers are habitual check bouncers. They not only bounce a check to me, but 100 other people. I'm one of the 100 victims of the check bouncers, sir. So a second time offender should be having a more stringent punishment, which is absolutely absent in this. And this is unfortunate, sir. Also, sir, the timely judgment, even the judiciary is not taking this up very seriously, sir. Very often it's merely a slap on the wrist. And I think the judiciary has to take note. Also, it is totally left to the judiciary what is the compensation they'll give. Is it the bank interest rate or any other compensation? Because of this check bouncing, I may have bounced a 1 lakh rupee check, and because the recipient of my bounced check will face another 10 lakh losses. So there's no compensation for check bouncing mentioned in this, sir. Another very important thing, sir, the big business houses are habitual check bouncers for small vendors, sir. They may be honoring the check of another big business houses, another big vendor, but I think small-time vendors are really cheated, and they have the audacity to say, do what you want. There's nothing you can do. You can go to the civil court. So this is very, very important, sir. We need to get this. And at the end, I'd like to conclude, sir. There's not much points I would like to make. I think the bill is very much required, but what is required is a even more stringent bill. We look forward for additional amendments to be bought by this government to make the sword even more sharper, sir. Thank you, sir. Sri.